520 miles north of Dutch Harbour. Elsa's unrelenting single-digit temperatures and thundering waves rock the Cornelia Marie.
This is some serious weather to be hauling gear in.
With their picking hook re-threaded, Casey and Josh are back to hauling pots.
We're still going strong fishing-wise. Pots are coming up full. We just have spray coming over right now, and spray sucks. And we have big rolls, and with full pots, big rolls suck.
Oh, 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 what's up?
Holy. And look at that one. That one's taller than the mast. If we get these shuffled, it's fishable. Safely fishable. Safe being a relative term. We're still crab fishing the winter on the Bering Sea.
We're not gonna push the luck any farther. Stack them up.
Roger! Alright. Going to this corner? Okay.
Casey's plan changed course and reset his gear to protect his freezing men from the wind and waves.
Give it a little tension. That's extend out.
Now, just hours after their picking hook line snapped,
it won't move down.
The portside crane seizes up.
This is not what we needed. Why?
What? Somebody need to go up?
Yeah.
Back in the harness.
That ain't dedication. I don't know what is.
Not cutting us any breaks today.
For the second time, deckhand Taylor Jensen makes a precarious ascent two stories above the icy deck.
Taylor's up there, strapped in. Well, he definitely wants to be an engineer on this boat, doesn't he?
Gotta go up top first.
Up there? Careful.
Are you cold yet? It's good to see a young guy that wants to get into this and do it, but I guarantee he's freezing his ass off right now. It is cold up there.
Well, it's broken off. It's broken off? Come look at it.
It says one of the bolts is broken in the top hat, like the top of the bolt head's missing. If that's the case, that could cause that thing to drop inside of there.
The bolts on the roto seal have snapped off, preventing the arm from rotating. In other words, the hydraulic crane arm is kaput.
So how do we fix that?
You take the thing apart.
Something we do out here.
Yes and no.
Oh.
I need to go look at this.
The time and money lost in a three-day trip back to port would turn Casey and Josh's far north gamble into a losing game of Russian roulette.
Casey's one of the best mechanics on the planet. So, hopefully get this done as fast as possible.
This is like Dutch Harbor call the hydraulic specialist kind of work here. Right now we're 480 miles away from Dutch. So we're gonna try to fix this on our own.
I can't get the bolt started.
On the Cornelia Marie.
There's too much ice, there's not enough alignment, there's not enough light, there's not enough anything. Like, I physically can't do it.
Burn the ice off of the torch and get the bolt in the pole.
Cramped inside the three-foot-wide base, co-captain Casey McManus races to fix the portside crane.
The bottom plate that holds the whole sleeve up to the core dropped off. It was in the bottom of the crane base with two bolts.
Vibrations caused by a broken bolt shook the crane's rotating mechanism loose from its seat.
The balance for a season hangs on this fix.
It's up to Casey to re-secure the loose parts to avoid further damage and get the crane and their season back on track.
Rotate it clockwise! Yeah!
Alright.
There!
How are we doing there, Cap?
I think it'll work.
Looks like they're testing it right now. We got her fixed.
Woo!
It was a nightmare, but we should be in a position now where all the functions should work again.
Josh and Casey may have put their equipment problems behind them.
We have probably 30, 35 foot seas out here, sub-zero temperatures.
But the ice-cold fury of Elsa isn't going anywhere.
Crab fishing wasn't intense already, then you add this to it. I'll tell you what, it's getting real.
Marks the end to a really day.